Hello guys. So it's me again. And our topic for today is laboratory quality management. So here I want to emphasize for all of the students, for my LabMan students or for anyone who are utilizing my video. So in this time, I'm just simply emphasizing the things that you need to remember and the must-knows in laboratory quality assurance. Actually, I'm already on the second page. So anyway, yeah. So please, those who have notes, bring out your notes. Kung sinong walang PDF, I'll think about it if I will link the PDF, okay? Because these notes are not mine. So for quality assurance, I just want to emphasize something here. So quality assurance is the complete system of creating and following procedures and policies to aim for providing the most reliable patient laboratory results and to minimize error in the pre-analytical, analytical, and post-analytical phase. Yan. It is quality assurance is concerned to the overall testing process. Yan. So it focuses on what happens in the pre-analytical stage, analytical stage, and post-analytical stage. Yan. So, sabi dito, yan, the most of the errors happens in the pre-analytical stage. Yan. So, it's very crucial. Kaya nga, sinasabi sa akin na dapat ang reception area, it should be like the eye of a needle. The receptionist, the one who is receiving, logging specimens and patients are one of the most crucial responsibilities in the laboratory, okay? Huwag minamaliit ang role ng receptionist, okay? So, starting from the selection of the test to giving the patient preparation, giving instructions, guys. So, kung mali yung na-instruct natin sa pasyente, wrong yung time ng fasting natin, wrong yung time ng abstinence if it's seminal analysis collection. So, madedelay yung paggawa natin ng test. At take note, mas lalo na kung admitted patient yan, tatagal ng tatagal yung pasyente sa pagkaka-admit kung hindi pa nagagawa yung test. Sometimes our results could be crucial that they would not release the patients yet. Okay, so kailangan i-prepare natin sila para masimulan na natin agad yung test nila, di ba? So misidentification, yan, I know someone who misidentified their patient, buti hindi sila na repeat section yan when they were an intern. So they had the same last name, sabi niya. So I forgot the last name, yan. So pa-extra kan daw yung pasyente, yan. Na sabi natin ang apelyido De La Cruz. Pumasok siya sa room at merong tao doon na De La Cruz, ayun, in-extra kan niya. Tapos meanwhile, may tumawag na, so bumalik na siya sa laboratory. Meanwhile, may tumawag sa na nurse galing sa ER, sabi niya, sana po yung mag-e-extra kay patient De La Cruz, hindi pa po siya na-extra kan. So, mali pala yung patient na na-extra kan niya, kamag-anak lang pala yon, yung pasyente nasa ER pa lang. Okay? So, that's such a crucial mistake. Okay? So, you have to be careful who are you extracting on. We have specimen collection, transport, yan, especially if you will be transporting swabs in viral transport medium, monitoring the specimen condition. Guys, alam nyo ba kung tama o yung stool, kung contaminated with water or urine, di ba? So, you have to check. Kung, kahit ayaw nyo tignan ang tae, di ba? So, kailangan nyo tignan. We have LIS receiving. We need to note it in our laboratory information system if you have received already our specimen. we sort and prioritize especially those results that are marked as stat, ganyan. We check for clots. You check mo kung tama ba yung na-receive mo, magka-match yung requisition tsaka yung label. So in the analytical phase, guys, quality control, reagent reconstitution, external and internal quality control is part of the analytical phase. Yan. Favorite kong tinatanong sa mga exam yan. Okay? So, every day we do external quality control. Internal quality control pala, I mean. And so, external is only once a year. So, internal, we do it every year. We run your quality control products. Yan. So, sa analytical phase yan. Okay, dapat ginagawa ang control araw-araw. Post-analytical phase, guys, ito, verification and validation of test results, delta check. Ito yung gusto kong i-highlight for this time. So, delta check, huwag niyong kakalimutan, guys. Dapat nasa puso't isipan niyo na yung delta check. Then it is when you compare the current results of the patient to their previous results. Okay, so especially when the patients, kunyari, the patient tested today, May 7. So, for kidney profile test, yan, tapos ang taas ng mga kidney result niya. So, if that patient is your regular patient, you should check his previous results on his kidney profile before you release the result, okay? Especially if the results are abnormally high compared to their historical results, yeah. And if you're unsure in releasing very abnormal kidney results, consult to your pathologist, yeah. Okay. So here, ayan, I want to emphasize, diba, yung internal and external quality control, okay? So, QC is in the analytical phase. Quality assurance is the whole testing process. O, alam niyo na yung sabihin ng QA at QC, ha? QC, it only happens in the analytical phase, okay? So, for the internal quality control, we do it every day, okay? It's a daily monitoring of the accuracy and precision, and we compile it every month, every 30 days, ha? Kino-compile nyo yan every month, okay? Hanggang makabuo kayo ng isang Levy Jennings chart, yan, hanggang 30 days na chart. Yan. So, hanggang 19 lang itong chart natin. So, dapat yun, hanggang 30 days, makabuo ka ng isang Levy Jennings chart, and that chart will be your guide whether you're in control or out of control. Yan. You evaluate it using Levy Jennings chart. Okay? So, it happens in the lab. So, it's QC within the lab. So, you purchase quality control products, you run controls before running the patient's sample, okay? So, sa pagtetest nyo, bago ka magsimula ng test mo during the day, ng pasyente mo, bago mo simulan yung mga pasyente mo, on that day, dapat mag-run ka muna ng quality control, okay? So, the control samples are bought by the laboratory, okay? However, for external quality control, this only happens once a year, okay? Wherein, unknown or blind samples are sent to the laboratory. So, if it's a parasitology external quality assurance, they bring you a stool sample with unknown results. So, ikaw magsasabi kung anong parasite ang andon. At kung hematology naman, bibigyan ka ng whole blood, yan, i-run mo sa CBC machine mo, di mo alam kung anong result nun. Okay? So, it is administered by a national reference laboratory. Okay? So, you run the unknown sample. Yan. And your results will be compared with other laboratories, okay? So lahat ng laboratories sa Pilipinas ay compelled, required, sumali sa external quality control. Okay? So, lahat ng mga laboratory magra-run ng parasitology, magra-run ng hematology, clinical chemistry, serology, HIV test, HepaB, ganyan. And the results will be evaluated using Z-score. Okay? So, parang ganito, guys. Yeah. So, eventually, all of the laboratories, yan, maipa-plot yung resulta na nila sa isang isang Gaussian distribution curve, okay? So, if your results are within the, around the mean, dito sa gitna, yan, it's highly satisfactory, it's excellent, okay? Pag lumampas ka, yun, depende sa ano yung equation, okay? So, if your results are past beyond 3SD, yan, dito, yan, you have poor quality results, okay? Dapat malapit ka sa my mean, okay? Yan, drawin ko muna, baka gamitin natin later. So, yan, naka-Z-score. So, dapat around the mean. So, pag around the mean, ibig sabihin, majority of the laboratories around the Philippines scored the same results. Yeah. So, dapat within 2SD. Yan. Pag lumabas ka ng 2SD, hindi na satisfactory yung results mo. So, guys, you don't have to worry anything. If you have good internal QC, papasa ka most probably sa external QC, okay? A good intra-lab quality control will result to a good proficiency testing. So, proficiency testing or external quality control. So, ang tawag sa Pilipinas, NECWAS, yung tawag ng NRL, National External Quality Assurance. Yan, tama ba? NECWAS. NEQAS. Yeah, NECWAS. Yeah. So, it will evaluate your performance. So, sa RITM, they use the term NECWAS. Yung iba, ECWAS, External Quality Assurance Scheme. Yeah. So, yan. Yeah. It's given by your National Reference Laboratory. Okay. So, guys, yan, yeah, most probably, yan, yeah, nobody really likes statistics. But for me, pag tumatanda ka, you fall slowly in love with statistics because, ano eh, for you to understand a lot of numbers, you need statistics, guys. Yan. So, kasi percentage, getting the average, di enough eh, di ba? You want to know if you're precise. Yan. Yan. You want to know if you're precise, kung maganda ba talaga yung resulta ng results mo, and you need to process it until coefficient of variation. So ano pang formula ng coefficient of variation? Yeah, so standard deviation over mean times 100%. Yan. So, madali lang pala isolve ang coefficient of variation. So, it will monitor your precision. Yan. So, if it's less than 5%, you are very precise. If it's more than 5%, di ka, oh, ang dali-dali lang, kukompute mo lang yung mean over standard deviation, makikita mo na kung precise yung test mo. Diba? Anong ibig sabihin? Yan. And guys, pag sinabing precise and accurate, magkaiba yun ha. Yan. Times 100. So, mean over standard deviation times 100. So, please, lalabas sa exam yan. Okay? So, ano bang ibig sabihin ng precise? When you have a test and it is and it's re and it's cons it consistently produce an accurate result, yan. So that your test is consistent, yan. So the results, ano pa ba? So, pag sinabi natin kasing accuracy, you are close to the, you are close to the true results. Yan. Pag sinabi nating accuracy, but precision, yan, nagana. You are, yan. Sorry, yan. Kailangan ko nag-google. Yan. Yan, parang puro target. Yan. Pero kasi tama naman talaga yung depiction eh. Pag bullseye, when you say that you are very accurate, you always hit the you're accurate, you hit the bullseye, okay? And if you are highly accurate and highly precise, so you do it 5 times, you do it 10 times, you do it 20 times, you are always close to the bullseye, okay? So, however, guys, if you are not precise, you are not precise when every other shot that you do, yan, malayo sa bullseye. Sometimes na-hit mo, sometimes hindi. So sometimes you are close to the true value of your glucose, sometimes you're not. You're becoming imprecise. Parang may sources, ano bang sources of imprecision sa laboratory? Guys, example, pipetting, ganyan. Or there are random errors that happens. So, ayun. Mamaya. Let's talk more about random and systematic error. So, yun isa rin sa ayoko makalimutan yun. So, CV is in percentage, okay? So, it's a measure of precision, di ba? Mean at standard deviation lang. Kailangan mo, malalaman mo na kung precise yung test mo, di ba? If not, pwede ka na mag-isip-isip. Pwedeng bumuli ka ng ibang reagent because the reagent that you bought is not precise. It's very unstable. Or pwedeng yung medtech mo kulang ng training or baka nasisira na pala yung makina mo. So, and we have maganda talaga tong Gaussian distribution curve. Yan. So, if you have a lot of data, marami kang numbers, guys. Eventually, ganito, all the numbers will plot as like a Gaussian distribution curve. Yan. Pag marami kang data, yan. Majority of the data will lie close to the mean, tapos beyond 1 SD, beyond 2 SD, and 3 SD. Yan. So, okay ka if you are within 2 SD. Yan. Hanggang dito. So, satisfactory pa yung results mo. Pero pag lumampas ka na ng beyond 2 SD, ay alanganin na yun. Okay. So, we have comparative statistics. Yan. So, wala, hindi nyo natatakpuhan itong p-value. So, after nakatest ka ng t-test, f-test, lagi lahat yan may p-value. Magtetest ka ng chi-square, magtetest ka ng z-test, magtetest ka ng ANOVA, lahat yan magpro-produce ng p-value, guys. So, if the p-value is greater than 0.05, yan. So, there is no statistical significance. And if it is less than, yun yung hinahanap natin, 0.05, there is statistical significance or difference. Yan. So, depending on your hypothesis. Yan. So, t-test, yan, para maintindihan nyo, two means. If you want to only compare sex and male and female, t-test lang yan. Pero pag 3 means, more than 2, ANOVA na yan. Di ba? Dali lang. Pag more than 2, greater than 2. 2 actually. Pag greater than 2, ANOVA ka na. 3, 4, 5. Yan. Z-test, it's like t-test, but for larger samples, talagang marami. Marami talaga. Like, sabi nga, buong Pilipinas. Result ng buong Pilipinas ng NECOAS. Yan. Z-test ang gagamitin natin. Yan. F-test daw, we compare the differences or variances. Yeah. So not means, but variances. Yeah. Nung sa coefficient of variation, yeah, and variances of two sample F-tests. Yeah. So it's precision. Yeah. T-test, two means. Yeah. Independent t-test. Okay, so andito na tayo sa isa sa favorite topic of tayos is differentiating sensitivity and specificity. Yes. So while I was walking home a while ago, sabi ko, how could I differentiate sensitivity and specificity? So when we say sensitivity, guys, the ability to detect even the smallest quantity of an analyte, okay? So, ang isang test natin, our analytical, our test, and analytical sensitivity, our method, is very sensitive if it could detect even the smallest of an analyte. Yan. So, napaka-sensitive ng test na napili natin, guys, kung kahit ang pinaka konting glucose, kaya niyang ma-detect. Napaka-sensitive ng test natin, guys, kahit na ang pinaka-konting COVID-19 virus, kaya niyang ma-detect. Just like our PCR. It has high analytical sensitivity. Your PCR, polymerase chain reaction, is very sensitive for COVID-19 testing. Yan. Kasi even though it has, you had the smallest quantity, ibig sabihin kahit nagsisimula pa lang yung test, kaya mo nang i-detect. Okay? Just like your P24 test for HIV testing. Yan. P24. That's the first antigen that comes out when you are first infected with HIV. So, your test would be really sensitive kahit konti pa lang na P24 na de-detect na ng test mo, okay? So, even though it's all about the volume or the quantity, okay? So, kahit konti. So, example, sabihin natin, sino ang light sleeper dito? Light sleeper. So, ibig sabihin, you are sensitive to even the smallest sound. Whatever sound it is, sound of a dog, sound of a baby, sound of a footstep, even though the sound is so small, you could detect it. Yeah. And so, you're a light sleeper. You are very sensitive to sound. Okay, so that's analytical sensitivity. How about analytical specificity? Okay, this is not about quantity anymore. Okay, this is not about quantity anymore, but the type of analyte it could detect. Yeah, that the analyte it could detect. Kasi guys, hindi natin matatanggi that our methods are sometimes imperfect. Okay, there are contaminations. There are contaminations. Okay, so sometimes this contamination will cross-react. Yan. Or sometimes, hindi lang contamination eh. Minsan, kunyari, may drugs kang ininom. It could affect the test. Yan. Imbis na yung antibodies lang ng COVID ang matetest, yan, it could detect other substances. Example is, for drug testing, imbis na metabolite lang ng marijuana ang nagtetest. Sometimes there are drugs or medications that cross react with the test at yun yung nadedetect nung test, kaya nagmumukhang positive ka pero hindi naman, nagpo-false positive ka pero hindi naman. So sometimes ganun. Okay, example, ano pa yung mga na test ng second year, micro, clinical chemistry. So, I think one of the common things that causes false positive in clinical chemistry is ascorbic acid. Yan. Yung mga nag-oxidate, mga oxidants. Yan. Kung, I don't know, tama ko. So, sometimes, some analytes cross-react. Okay? So, if you're test method has high analytical specificity, it could only detect the analyte which it is designed to measure. Okay? So, kunyari, may pregnancy test ka. Yan. May pregnancy test kit ka. Dapat, it should only measure HCG, yan, human chorionic choriono HCG choriono-gonadotropin. Yan, kung tama ko ha. So, kung ang mga sa pregnancy test kasi, HCG ang dinedetect. Okay? So, your baby placenta will, your fetus will produce HCG if you are pregnant. Yan. So, kung very specific yung preg test natin, guys, it will only detect that. Okay? However, guys, meron kasing condition na H-mol. Yan, H-mol. And this H-mol produces hydatid mole. Yan. H-mol na lang. This is a tumor that could be found among females or males na nagproproduce ka rin ng HCG sa ihi. Okay? So, ayun, it could cross-react to your preg test na magpa-positive ka. So, ang mga lalaki pwedeng mag-positive sa preg test. Hindi dahil buntis sila, but meron dahil silang tumor. Tumor na which is HMOL, which also produces HCG. So, may ang mga methods natin, guys, meron silang limitation, okay? So, your pregnancy test kit that are bought in Watson, guys, is talagang it's reliable naman in getting test results for pregnancy test, okay? Okay siya ha, don't get me wrong. Pero, those who have HMOL condition, pwede rin silang mag-positive sa pregnancy test. Yan. So, ayon, guys. So, in such a way, it's parang may pagka-low specificity ang pregnancy test kit. Okay? Kaya kailangan magpa-ultrasound rin yung mommy o kaya magpa-test ng HCG sa dugo mismo, sa serum. Okay? To increase the precision whether a woman is pregnant or not. Okay? Not only relying on pregnancy kits. Kasi nga may mga cross-reactivity. Pati sa mga drug testing kits, guys, yan. May mga cross-reactivity yan. So, ayun, test is very specific if it will only test the analyte which is designed to detect and measure. Okay, just like PCR. It's highly specific as well, okay? Because it will only multiply, it will only amplify the genetic material of COVID-19. And very very precise ang PCR kasi nga meron siyang primers. Yan. Malalaman nyo na yun pag nag-malbayo na kayo. Okay. So, before we go on to diagnostic sensitivity and diagnostic specificity, ganun pa rin yung concept, pero nakatuon na sa mga tao. Okay? So, meron lang tayong mga ayokong kalimutan nyo ng mga terms. We have true positive. Yan. So, true positive, a person is truly has that condition. Yan. Has the disease. Diba? True positive talaga. True talaga. Yan. Pag false positive, the person was given a diagnosis that they have the disease, but in reality, they do not have the disease. They are positive, they were given a positive result, but they do not have the disease. Problema yan, yung mga nagpa-false positive. Na negative naman talaga sila sa totoong buhay, pero dahil sa pagkakamali sa diagnostic or sa analytical method, naging false positive sila tuloy. So guys, I don't know if you know it yet, that HIV back then, its confirmatory method is Western blot. Yan. So HIV dati, before 2021, ang confirmatory test ng HIV is Western blot. Yan. So, now, this 2023, that's not the case anymore. Because they found out na sa Western blot, maraming nagfo-false positive ng HIV. Ibig sabihin, negative talaga sila, pero binibigyan sila ng positive result ng test. Okay? So now, instead of doing Western blot, we do immunochromatographic test. Yan. So parang yung mga test kits na rin ngayon, pero very sensitive and very specific yan. Fourth generation, third generation na ang mga ginagamit niya. So, yun. Marami nagpo-false positive doon. So, pag sinabi natin true negative, yan. Negative yung result ng pasyente at negative talaga siya. Yan. Wala talaga siyang sakit. True negative. Pero false negative, ito mahirap to, binigyan ng medtech ng negative na result, pero the patient has the disease. Yan. So, guys, ito yung mga iniiwasan natin. Yung mga false negative and false positive. Okay? So, guys, yun. So, dapat very specific, very sensitive yung mga resulta natin para maiwasan natin ang mga false positive at false negative. Yan. So, tingnan natin. So, let's move on. So, diagnostic sensitivity. Proportion of individuals with the test who test positively with the method over the percent of population with the disease that test positive. Yan. So, lahat. So, 100 times lahat ng true positive. Yan. Over lahat ng may sakit. So, false negative at mga true positive. These are all sick people. Yan. They are sick. Sick. The total number of sick people. So, to get if your diagnostic method is truly sensitive, yan, how do you compute it? So, 100 times the true positive people over the number of people who are sick. Yan. So, yan, lahat ng may sakit. How to determine the specificity? Yan. So, 100 times true negative, yan, plus the total number of those who are healthy. Di ba ang mga false positive? Yan, healthy naman talaga yung mga yan. Pero binigyan kasi ng positive result. Yan. Healthy. Yan, basta alam nyo na yan. So, lahat ng walang sakit. Over, so the denominator is the total number of those who are not sick. Yan. Di ba, walang sakit naman ang mga false positive. Ang false negative, di ba, may sakit naman talaga yan. So, that's how you compute yan. So, ewan ko kung tinatanong ito sa board exam, yung computation ng diagnostic specificity and sensitivity. But sensitivity, the true positive is in the numerator and those who are all sick are in the denominator. 100 times the true negative and over the total number of those who are supposedly healthy. Yan. Pag true negative, di ba, healthy ka naman kasi wala kang sakit. Yan. At false positive, healthy ka rin. However, binigyan ka ng positive na result. Okay? So, other than that, ayan, actually, meron tayong, I don't know if this would help. Yan. So, true positives, yan, are people who are sick and false positives are people who are also sick but given a negative result. Yan. So, true positive over the total of true positive plus false is your sensitivity. Your false positive, yan, are healthy. Yan, false. Yan. Healthy naman talaga sila, pero binigyan ng positive result and true negatives are healthy talaga. So true negative over the total of healthy people, yan. That's how you compute your specificity. Yan. So if you want to compute lang naman the specificity and sensitivity of your test. So pang research to, guys. And We have positive predictive value. So PPV, guys, is the probability that a positive test indicates the presence of disease, percent of time that a positive result is correct. So how many times? And actually, I think during the time of COVID, nagko-compute sila ng positive predictive value. So kung ilan yung mga positive result na our presence of disease, probably that indicates the presence of kung ilan yung na-detect na positive result nung method. Yan. And how many are the negative results that are detected by the method. Yan. So, very easy lang, true positive over the true positive plus false positive is your PVV, and your false true negative over true negative over false negative. Yan. True negative. Yan. Laging ang mga nasa numerator, true positive and true negative. Yan. True negative, true positive. Yan. So, pa horizontal naman to. Yan. TP plus FP, FN plus TN. Yan. Yung numerator. So, that's your negative predictive value. Yan. So, this is for research, actually. So, huwag niyong kakalimutan yung definition, difference between sensitivity and specificity. Yan. Sensitivity is all about the quantity. So, how much? So, the lesser the volume the test could detect, yan, the better. Okay? So, may naming tests na ngayon that are highly sensitive. Okay? At actually, may limits rin, di ba? May sensitivity limits rin ang mga test, okay? Not all could detect a very small volume. Yan. At may limit rin kung gano'ng kataas yung kaya nilang i-measure, okay? Walang infinite number. So, Lex is quality control program. So, still, we are in the analytical phase, okay? So, we have quantitative quality control. So, these are the quality control materials that your medtech runs. Okay? So, bumibili siya ng known na value na normal. At, so, sa bi-level QC program, dalawa lang yung quality control niya na reagent. Normal na alam niya yung known results and abnormally high. Because this is the one that is required by your CLIA. Kahit dalawa lang, okay na. However, yan, kung gusto mo talagang maganda yung result mo, kuha ka ng abnormally low na result, na known result, normal and abnormally high. Yan. So, just a review. So, if you will run the normal results in your glucose test, it should come out as a normal result. So if your machine would run the normal specimen, tapos ang result abnormally low or abnormally high, there's something wrong with the reagent, the pipetting, the equipment. So, ma'am, ganun pala yun. Pag abnormal yung labas ng QC program, ang raming sources of something wrong. Yes, yan talaga. So, ang role ng medtech, kaya hindi tayo pinapalitan ng robot, guys, is you have to know where is the problem coming from. Okay? Yan. So, yan. Kunyari, baka nagluma na yung reagent mo, kailangan mo na magbukas ng bagong reagent. Ganyan. So, ayun. So, tri-level. I think most of the laboratory, tri-level, normal, abnormally high, and low. And we have qualitative quality control. Yan. Positive and negative control lang. So, yan. If the, I think usually this is used in your immunochromatographic methods, sa mga test kit. Yan. So, kung kunyari, dinarapan mo ng positive result, o di dapat, ano, maglinya yung test. Yan. There should be a line on the test. If it's a negative result, a control, then there should be no line on the test. Yan. Di ba, linya-linya lang naman sa mga yung mga mukhang pregnancy kit. Yan. So, ganun sa drug test, Ganun sa mga H, hepatitis. Okay. So, our calibrators. Your calibrators are also known as standard. They measure accuracy. Yan. So, how close are you to the true value? Yan. So, this is a reference material. So, it is used to calibrate the instrument, used to calculate the concentration of control and patient samples. Ayun, it is a calibrator. Yan. It's a standard. So, so in the computation of your absorbance, hindi ba kailangan ng standard? So, used to establish reference points in the construction of graphs. Yan. So, the calibrator is so much different than the control, okay? So, the control will measure your precision. Yan. So, how consistent your results are. Yan. So, they chemically and physically resemble the patient's specimen. Yan. So, meron kang control, which are normal levels. May control na abnormally high. Merong control na abnormally low. Yan. So, be tested in the same way as patient specimens. You use it daily. So, mabilis maubos ang control at mahal ang control, guys. Yan. With known concentration of the analyte. Okay. And guys, we're almost done. So, merong mga graphs. Yan. Cumulative sum graph. It is for indication, gives the earliest indication of systematic errors. So when we say systematic errors, this happens, this type of errors are happening very slowly. You don't notice it immediately. And you will see the error as trends. Yan. So either may pa-increase or may decrease in your Levy-Jenkins chart. So, maganda pala na makakita ng trend sa cumulative sum graph. Okay? Kasi sa Levy-Jenkins, after 30 days, mo na makikita eh. We have Uden plot, yan, for interlab comparison, yan. Interlab naman to. So, you're for external QC naman to. And we have Levy-Jenkins chart or Shewhart plot, yan. So, this is most commonly used, yan. So, merong x-axis, may y-axis, at hindi ba, may mean, yan, nasa gitna ang mean. Tapos, to compute 1SD, so mean, plus minus 1 times your standard deviation para makuha mo yung mga SD values. Yan. May example pa tayo. So, meron tayong word na shift. Okay? So, shift, ang clue mo dito, when the results are only on the one side of the mean. Okay? Wala kang pakialam kung pataas o pababa. As long as it's only on the lower side of the mean. Yan. Mapapansin mo, ha? Ba't lahat ang marami na one side of the mean? So, huwag mo lang hintayin na maging 10x, di ba? Na maging 10. Yan. Pag marami na, ano na yan? Shift na yan. Okay? Huwag malilito sa pangalan. So, shift mukhang pataas, di ba? But no, okay? It's on one side of the mean. And its main cause is improper calibration of the instrument. Okay? Don't forget that. Next trend. Ayan, may trend. Ayan. So, trend if it's either going down or going up. Okay? So, the side of the mean doesn't matter. Okay? As long as there's a pattern that you could see that's increasing or decreasing for 6 days. Ayan. Example is, your reagents are slowly deteriorating. Example pa, kunyari your lamp is slowly deteriorating. Ayan. So, ayun, there's something slowly happening, yan. Diba? Nasisira nang pa konti-konti yung makina mo. Baka yung control reagent muna pala. Yan, expired na. Yan. Outlier, yan. This is just super random result, yan. That goes beyond 2SD, yan. And you should investigate it. Parang, ba't ha? Ba't biglang out of place. Yan. So, ito, 10x, it's a shift. Yeah. Pero huwag mo na paabutin ng 10, di ba? May days bang sinabi? Paabutin ng 10 bago mo sabihin there's a shift. So there's improper calibration of your equipment. Okay? So, reviewin na lang natin itong Westgard rules. Okay? So, 2S, 3S, itong side na to guys, itong mga naka-subscript, these are your signs. Yan. Ito yung clue mo. So, pag sinabi natin 4-1S, ibig sabihin, may apat na nakatambay sa 1S. Ibig sabihin, 4 consecutive control values exceed your 1ST. Apat na ang beyond 1ST. Yan. And it should alarm you. But apat na ang nakatambay sa 1ST? It shows a systematic error. Okay? So, errors that happen slowly. Yan. So, deterioration, calibration, drifting, instability. Kasi dapat hindi sila nagsistay sa isang one side lang. Marami pa ha. So, 2-2S. So, dalawa ang nakatambay sa beyond 2-2S. Okay? That should be your sign. So, dapat pag binabasa mo pa lang, hindi ka nalilito. Kunyari, sabi mo nito, 3S, 1-3S. Ibig sabihin, merong isang lumampas sa 3S. 1-2S. So, may isang lumampas sa 2S. R, 4S. Okay? Walang 4S sa Levy Jennings. Pero may gap na 4S. There's a range or there's a gap of four steps. Yan. On the two consecutive control value. Masyado silang magkalayo. Yan. That's a random error. Yan. Biglang may fluctuation. Random error. Bigla-bigla na lang nangyayari. Systematic. These are errors that happen slowly. Okay? So, dapat, hindi na nalilito, guys. Please, do not allow. Hindi, wag hayaang lumampas kayo ng lab man na hindi alam ito. Please, utang na loob, nakakahiya. So, 1-3S, 1 control exceeded 3S. Okay? The 3SD. 2S, 1 control exceeded either positive 2S or negative 2S. Yan. So, dito sa taas, yan. Lumampas na to ng 2S. Ito, negative 2S. O, lumampas rin to. So, pwedeng sabihin natin na itong 18, yan. 1-2S yan. Yan, may isa eh. Pero guys, kung bilangin nyo, 1, 2, 3, 4, apat na steps yung pagitan nila. So, this is 4R4S. Yan. Bilis ko naman, di ba? Yan. So, mapapansin nyo dito, yan, mukhang okay naman kasi pa-alternate, ganyan. Pero, yan, kunyari, meron ng lumampas dito na apat, 1, 2, 3, 4, ano kaya itong tawag dito? 4, 1S. Yan, lumampas na ng may apat na lumampas sa 1S. Ito, tumapat sa 3S. So, ito, 1, 3S. Yan. So, this is a random error. This is also a random error. Ito, this is a systematic error. Kung merong ganyan. Okay? So, ganun tumingin. Diba yung pa-quiz ko na, what is wrong with day 18, kunyari, day 18. So, tingnan mo lang yung wag yung day 18 lang. Pati yung katabi. So, ito, dalawa, lumampas sa 2S. So, 2S. Yan. Yan. So, pag dalawa na, dumadalawa na, this is a sign of systematic error. Yan. Yung mga usually magkakatabi, nagkakos yun ng mga systematic error. Yung mga magkakalayo, nagkukos ng random errors. Kaya nga random, eh, biglang random naman ang ginawa nun. Yeah. So, kung ano, pataas pa rin to ng pataas, diba, pwedeng sabihin natin, kung marami pa to at pataas pa rin, nasabing 30. Okay? So, kunyari, kung marami, yung mga nasa taas na min na to, yan. Kunyari, parami ng parami yung mga min, mga dots, control values na nasa taas dito, yan. It's a shift. So, shifts and trend are systematic errors. Okay? So, ayun, guys. Mag-practice naman na tumingin ng Levy Jennings. So, basta-basta lang. Okay? Yung pumayag because, you know, ano, alam nyo na sa board exam nyo lang siseryosohin. Okay? So, I hope you have learned something for today. And I'll see you on our exam day. Bye-bye, guys.